But you need to consider the difference between the mobile and the brick and mortar and the difference. I mean, the main thing is definitely the financial. It will be different. The brick and mortar is going to be more than the mobile. But at the same time, you have to recognize that the gross sales is going to be different between both concepts, because the fact that with a brick and mortar, you're going to have several staff in that 1,000 square foot. But with the mobile, you know, let's say if you have a 24 feet van, you're going to have, you know, one, maybe two staff. So in order for you to keep growing, you have to keep buying more mobile. And then as far as being a business owner of the mobile versus the brick and mortar, the mobile require more discipline as far as, you know, you're gonna want to take as much clients you can, because it's money you're about to make. But with mobile, the people are not coming to you, you're going to them. So you have to recognize the distance, the gas, the time. So you might have a client like, wait, I have this one dog over here, you know, and you're like, wow, that's great, I'm gonna go out there and do that dog to get that sale. But if you don't recognize that the next one is far away, you're about to lose more money, because the fact that it takes a good amount of time to go out there, a good amount of time to go to your next client, and at the same time, also the gas, and you have to be aware of the gas price. So it requires a lot more, you know, pretty much a lot more discipline to run the mobile. And at the same time, you have to have greater communication skill, because not all your staff are in one place like the brick and mortar. Your staff is spread out. So you have to have great communication with them and them with you at the same time, and also great leadership to teach them better communication. So that would be the main difference between the brick and mortar and mobile.